Hello there, Sailor with the Armageddon Report. Let's jump on over to the Northwest Pacific. Well, we've got a new one. Tropical Depression Properin. Why? Because I have no idea how to pronounce it in its target language. Ergo, it becomes a Scottish name to me. Because it looks... It needs a Scottish pronunciation. That is my take on the matter. Right, so the JTWC has this thing becoming the equivalent of a Category 3 hurricane and booking fairly westward. Some of the spaghetti models there showing it, you know, booking north and curving back to the east. So that'll be something to keep an eye on. Right now, though, only near gale marine warnings as per the JMA. So not a whole lot of land impacts or marine impacts as of yet. But potential future impacts maybe to mainland China, Taiwan, maybe the Philippines, depending on if it takes a curve and goes a different path. Who knows? It's very far out from all of these places as of now, so that's a bit of a gesturing, I don't know, to say, hey, yeah, it might affect them. And then over in the eastern Pacific, Tropical Storm Olivia. Right, who has no land hazards? Because Olivia's just out in the middle of nowhere at the moment. Of course, if you're a boat out there, or on a ship or something, you probably don't think of it as the middle of nowhere. And then 20% chance of tropical cyclone formation out in this area here. And just, what is that, two spaghetti models? Oh, we got XTRP, which is not really a spaghetti model. And the CLP5, which I think has something to do with... I have no idea. I can't remember what it stands for. Yes, or maybe it says CLPS. No, that's definitely a 5. Anyway, so, but that's pretty low at this moment, 20% chance. So we'll keep an eye on that. Or we, as in the National Hurricane Center, shall keep an eye on that. Active weather hazards, all of the wintery type things moving over to the east. So what colors do we have today? We have freeze warnings. That's all of these light bluish things. We've got freeze watch is this darkish blue. There'll be a freeze warning back there. Red flag warnings, that's the fire weather back then, Oregon. Right, and one more, we have frost advisory. So I believe in terms of badness, right, which is a word, it goes freeze warning, freeze watch, frost advisory is probably the in terms of severity, that's probably how it goes. Yes, a warning in the United States. So anyway, warning always worse than a watch, just, you know, I have no mnemonic for that. It just, you know, a warning is always worse than a watch. Watch means it's potential and it's gonna happen. It may happen soonish. Warning means it's happening right now, baby. And we actually have severe thunderstorm news to talk about. Well, at least for a smallish area. South Carolina and North Carolina apparently today with a 15% chance of winds, 5% chance of a hail. Nothing going on as of the moment, though. Here's your wind map. So this would be the probability of winds 58 miles per hour and greater. So basically a coastal threat. Hail-wise, same-ish area, however, only 5%. And tornadoes apparently not really forecasted today. So yeah, that's where you pay attention today. But nothing kicked on. Nothing kicking on as of yet. SevereWeatherTV.com is the official homepage of this screencast. WikiWix is WikiWX.com. And CycloCane is CycloCane.com. That's it for today. Enjoy the rest of your lovely weekend.